Bella. Welcome back to my channel. Now we're in Forgotten Hollow. I'm continuing with Victoria, the vampire that I made before. So I've moved her into a house, and this was like the only house that was affordable. Otherwise, there's like a lot. And this one was too expensive, and these two are occupied. So I'm gonna go in, and we're gonna have a look at the place. So, we're here with Victoria McQueen, and, look at her eyes. Look how awesome she looks. It's beautiful. Close that. First thing I'll say is I'm loving the eyes. And they have a little bat thing around the, don't know what it's called. I'm just going to call it the little sim pointer icon thing. Probably figure out what it actually is called after. So we have a little planter box. We got a little bush here. Chair. This is the house. This is what it looks like on the outside. So that's pretty snazzy. So this is how it looks. We got trees and stuff. Now we're going to go. If I could get control of the camera, that would be nice. Look inside here. So we've got the kitchen area with little cobwebs and stuff, and that's part of the vampire pack, I believe. We're gonna go into that soon. We don't really have much money, so not really gonna redecorate now. I might get her to get like work a bit more, get some money, and then once there's enough money, I'll redecorate. And so that's that. We've got a little computer over here, a little TV, couch, more cracks, windows like this, wallpaper, got the bathroom and the bedroom. Okay, so I'll show you what's in build mode that's new. So, I wonder if we can filter it by pack. Can we? Yes. Vampires. Alright, so we have resting ground, which is a styled room, but I'm not sure if we can put that anywhere just to even view it. No, so I'll just view it here. So it's got like a statue and stuff, and a gate, and like gravestones. Hall of Devouring, so like a dining room, I'm guessing. Yes, a dining room, a little den with a fireplace and a bar. We've got an organ, which is new, and yeah, that kind of stuff. And we've got a bedroom, which that is a freaking awesome bedroom. I want that bedroom. My favorite color is purple, and my favorite colors are purple and black, so that just looks like perfect. We have this where it has coffin and everything, because vampires can sleep in coffins, they can also woohoo in coffins. Then we've got a little bathroom. And that's pretty much that for that bit. Got little Victorian cabinets. I want to see if it, I'm not going to put it anywhere, but I just want to see what it looks like. So they look like that. We got little countertops. And they look like that. It's one. Here's the other one. A cuckoo cachoo skull. That just. Okay. Alright then. Then we got an iron radiator. And we got an antique book stand. That just makes me think of the Book of Shadows and Charmed. We got a large decorative urn, which can change the colors and stuff. And then we've got a floor cabinet, which just looks like something you'd put potions and stuff in. I wonder if they're gonna bring witches and stuff eventually. Maybe. I'm hoping they do. I love witches. We got a gothic pedestal sink. Ooh, we have drapes. Okay, and now we're gonna go to. Is there anything else? Lights. Okay, so we have a spooky candelabra. A little lamp with tassels. Got a candle chandelier. Got a large chandelier. That bloody brightens up a room. Got a floor lamp. We have another floor lamp. And ones that go on the wall. Okay, bathroom. Toilets. We have this old-fashioned high tank toilet. Which looks pretty darn fancy. And, mirrors. The gilded bat mirror. Bat centerpiece that prominently featured adds a touch of style to any bathroom and room. That looks pretty snazzy. Then we got a widow's peak mirror. And, then we've got floor mats, so we've got rugs. Large rugs. Different colours and stuff, obviously. Go here. We got a little Victorian bath towel. Wait, can we change it to daytime for a second? So I can see stuff. Alright. There. Well, apparently I can't even look at that. God, we need money. Anyway, you can put holes in the wall. So, like, large ones, medium. Multiple small holes. Cracks. Spider webs. As you can see. You can have little ripped tears. Large tear. A large hole, different kinds of holes, water stains, which that doesn't look very nice. A hanging ceiling cobweb. That's just creepy. Ancient family portraits. Moonlit rose in the garden, which, where can I view that? Come on. So, like, yep, there. A shrubbery tapestry. It's gonna say tapestry. A floor cobweb. No cobwebs. That's gross. Spiders creep me out. We got a new alarm clock. I can't even open that because we have insufficient funds. Oh my god. So that's that bed that I showed you that was in that purple room when we were looking at the style rooms. Now that is something I want. Now we have an aged wooden coffin. And then more types of coffins. And obviously change colours. Yada yada. Oh yeah, I can't show you that. So we've got like large living chairs like that. Stone-hearted love seat. We've got a thrill of the chase lounge, and then we've got the gothic love seat, but I can't use that either because we don't have enough money. I don't want to use money cheats. I'm trying to refrain from that and just have them work because I've done that in one of my other save files where I've just given loads of money and built a gigantic house. I don't want to do that with the ones that I record though. So little pedestals. An imp gargoyle, a fairy gargoyle, forgotten woman statue, a winged llama of death, the winged gargoyle, fairy's help, forged queen, headstones, there we go, headstones, what else? Dining room stuff. Alright. So, we have a little Victorian table, and we've got another one there that I can't show you, but it's bigger. Chairs. This, I love this. not just for the fact that it's purple, but I just love it. And then we got this one. Got wall decorations. So like ivy and stuff. All that kind of stuff, which you can already sort of like see. Yeah, and then we got a new bar, but I can't show you that either because we don't have money. We've got the organ that I showed you before and that same bar that was just before there. The kids' room. Oh, that is so cute! They put a little like goth bassinet. That is so cute. What's in here? Hello? Never mind. And then they got Becula. That's so cute. I love it. Nothing else? That's it? Alright, what about wallpapers? Okay, so we have new wallpapers. And, can you see that? Maybe if I go over here. So that's one of them. Here's the other one. Different colors, obviously. Red, yellow, that color. I think that's the one that's in here. Can I change that? Can I have that purple? Yeah, we're good. Alright, we're good with that. I really like that. It's beautiful. That's wallpaper. Any painting? No, that wasn't wallpaper. That was paint. Oh my god, I'm so confused. Anyway, there's these as well. They have just like different patterns on them. So like... See? Or, that. Any bricks? New bricks? No. Oh, we have new paneling. We have new bricks. No rocks. No miscellaneous. Alright. Floor. We have new wood, which I wanna do for the bedroom because I don't like light wood. I like dark. Or we have this one, but I prefer that one, which is the Victorian pocket. I don't like the styled pocket. Pocket? Am I saying it right? Then we have this one, or this one, and these tiles, or these tiles, this stone. That's pretty much it for that. Doors. Alright, so we have the... I can't even show you. Alright. Can we, I'm gonna remove this just for the moment. So we have that kind of door. Or that kind of door. Which I do like that one. How much is it? We'll have that one. I like that one. Okay. That's all there was. No, there's more. So, mausoleum gate. And arches. Okay, fencing. So, we have iron Victorian fence. So, it looked like that. Then we have this slim fence. Looks like that. Then we have Victorian fence like that, a concrete one. Then iron railing. Okay. Little doors, which look okay. They're not little. They're huge. Huge gate that looks like this. Do we have rails? We have little stairway rails, which we'll put there because they look pretty fancy. Well, they could look like that. So we've got different windows as well. Is there any place that I could put a window, please? Without you, like, being rude. Come on. Up here? No. But hold on, there's large windows. Can I remove a window just to test this out? Alright, so there's one there that's like that. Then we have this one. And these ones. This one. And I'm guessing that one's that one. Yes. Okay. So we're gonna undo. So we can have that back. Got little wall sculptures as well, so you could have like a gargoyle. And I can't show you them, but there's a hanging werewolf apparently. Stuff like that. There are little roof linings that you can do. There's little structural things like that. Columns. There's new trees, apparently. So, dry pine tree. We have a scraggly tree. A dead hawthorn tree. This is a pretty big lot for like a small house. A bare pine tree, which is these ones. Then you can have little roof thing. It's pretty cool. Alright. Werewolf gargoyle on the house. It's like, I'm about to eat you! I would jump off the roof! And then a roof vent. Okay, that's pretty snazzy actually. Is there anything else here? There's a wall shelf. I think that's the last thing I had to show you guys. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I pretty much show you guys all of it. Okay, so I'm gonna go in now and we're going to just play around a little bit. So, Victoria, let's go inside your cute little house and study some vampire secrets. Search for information on vampires. Come on, lady. Victoria, get your butt in here. Walking like a creep. Oops. We'll keep the walls down for now. Just so I can see what she's doing. Discovered vampire secrets. Victoria is delving deep into researching vampires. There seems to be a lot of knowledge she could unlock if she continues to research. So, let's look at the needs now, because that's different. The icon's different, and all this is different. So, vampire energy. Vampires use vampire energy to perform powers and protect themselves from the harsh rays of the sun. Recover vampire energy by sleeping or using dark meditation. Victoria read that garlic and plasma fruit can be found. Hello, I was reading. Can be found in Forgotten Hollow. Unlocked Vampire Tomb. Victoria has discovered the Von Flavius Vampire Emporium while searching for vampires. I'm going to pause before you walk off. She can now purchase Encyclopedia Vampirica Volume 1 on the computer under Vampire Secrets. Let's just calm down. Calm down, Victoria. Thirst. Vampires do not get thirsty very often. But be sure to drink from Sims or eat plasma fruit when they do. Otherwise, they might attack a nearby sim without warning. That sounds pretty scary. Social. Social's normal. Hygiene's normal. Fun's normal. This is... Oh, your rank. So, fledgling vampire. And the next one's a minor vampire. You have vampire powers as well. So, at the moment, we only have, like, 2 power points. Power points. You can use. Okay, so these are her weaknesses. Well, these are some weaknesses. With its stomach, she can vomit when eating human food. Guilty drinker. She'll become guilty when drinking from Sims without permission or uncontrollable hissing. Okay, so some of the powers that you can get is detect personality, which learns about another's all about another Sim's traits. Do away with tedious conversations and getting to know others. Victoria will learn other Sims' personalities instantly by visiting their frontal lobe herself. Bat form. Gain the ability to fly anywhere as a bat. Nobody ever suspects the bat, and no one certainly won't suspect Victoria flying about as such. Move from hither to yon and even find love as a Sony-wielding creature of the night. Cast hallucination. Make another Sim talk to themselves. Everyone needs a friend, yes. What if the friend is one of Victoria's devising? And what if it doesn't really exist? No one will be able to tell. Eternally welcome. Gain the power to lock and unlock doors at other Sims' homes. Having to ask permission to enter the home is so pedestrian. Not only may Victoria enter her home without invitation with just a small burst of vampire energy, she can lock and unlock doors as she sees fit. She sees fit. Will she wreak lock havoc? Of course. Occult student, use less vampire energy. Victoria is beginning to study her vampiric energy and the many ways it can be used. She can expend less energy for the same effect. Further study will reduce vampire energy costs even more. Okay, now we can get back to what we were doing. Skills, vampire lore is a skill now. So the first thing she wants to do is purchase a vampire creation power. Gain power points to spend on blah blah blah. Okay. Hey! People are here. Why? Okay, invite in. Hello. How are you?
Niara. Pompo. Ina Tribna. Vimpa Dashuna Larkim.
Let's be
Sure.
friendly. Let's
Gungane.
ask about
Sneara.
day.
Blah blah.
Yes, I am a
Yulabordine.
vampire.
Spina. Shinoi.
What do you need to know about it, you rude lady? Let's I'm gonna make a vampire pun.
Boonamoosh,
Something
Boom
about teeth.
Bam,
Yeah, it's so
Saga.
funny. She probably didn't like that. Well, then get out of my house. Leave.
Sneara's
Nobody
on.
wants you here. Leave. Get
Rabna,
out.
Mog.
Get out of Victoria's house.
Dag Dag.
Turn you off. We are going to. I think we'll, Hey. Where did he go? Did nobody else see him standing there? Where did he? Hello? Is it you? No, you. You're a bird, not a bat. Oh, screw it. All right, Victoria. What we're going to do is we're going to buy Encyclopedia of Vampirica, Volume 1. It's $75. That's a fair bit for a book. Alright, now we're gonna read. Read more. Oh, it was a sad movie. Is everything okay?
Bonzoi Felina.
Yes, you're going to read. Going to read, and I'm gonna see if there's. Who are you? You were in the trailer, weren't you? Caleb Vator. It's I'm not going to speak to you. I'll just wait around to see who are you? Masato Kobayashi. I think that's how you say it. What are all these people doing walking around at night? Don't you know you're around vampires? We'll eat you. Okay, Victoria. Vampire, we can do dark meditation or show dark form. Victoria read that vampires can be out during the day as long as they have a ceiling over their head, which stops the most powerful of sun rays. You know what would be cool if they had an umbrella that they could carry around? To, like,
Ephedra.
All right, keep reading. Discovered that there is an alternative method for vampires to satisfy their thirst, and she can now order plasma packs on the computer. Victoria read that there is a special drink concoction which can allow vampires to walk in the daylight for a limited time. That's pretty handy. Let's go visit somebody. It's nighttime, I know, but somebody's got to be awake. We'll visit. Is it this house? I don't remember whose house it is. Okay, so we're here. Lilith Vator is looking like Betty Page over here. Okay, so is this your residence? I can't get over her walk. She's such a little weirdo. She's like, oh, I'm going to get you. Thank you. Why? What a lovely house you have. Whose house am I in? Running upstairs, or is it you guys that are downstairs? Is it your guys' house? It is your guys' house. Oh, I feel bad. Hey! Friendly introduction. Friendly introduction. Can I request vampiric training? Come on! Oh my god, did you see that? How far she's going? She went, sorry. No, train me. That's cool. Let's go! That's cool. Maybe that's hallucinating him? That kind of thing? Thanks, man. Could we also get some more training? No, you can only do training. Ah, I can only wait. I have to wait? Why? Why do I have to wait? Ah, a new child of the night. As an elder vampire, it is my honor to welcome you to our family. Your new thirst for plasma takes some getting used to. Remember, thirst can be uncomfortable, but it won't kill you. Here are some plasma packs to keep you. It scrolled up. To keep you fed for the first few days. Just stay out of the sun and you'll be fine. Thank you. Give me a heartfelt compliment.
English? Kando.
Mobsy.
Shabini. Woon. Gushong. Tribnathenib.
Oh, Moosh Bepso. Sloofa Woomba.
Can't do anything.
Sternzerpanooch. Galoomba.
Donna Boona. Gorba.
All right, we're just telling some jokes to our friends here, Lilith and Caleb. Why does that sound familiar? Can anybody tell me why it sounds familiar? Because it's just not going to click in my head. Vampire. Nothing.
Dope. a harfin.
Oh.
Complimenting the house. That is so nice of you, Victoria. Get to know them a bit. And then tell a dramatic story. There he is. Vlad is Lestrade. Let's just call him Vlad. And yeah. Sorry about that. I was messaging. Talking about crabs, really? Oh no, this lady, right? A bitter, but she had crabs. No? Too much? Too far? I want to walk, I want to run that fast. Run. Hey, you, human! No, we'll do not.
Mimlet?
Alright, say goodbye. Time to go home.
Avenue's Mishy.
So their house is pretty damn awesome. Okay, so we are back home now. And I think I am going to call it a day. Get back inside because the sun's coming out. I think I'm going to call it a day. And we're going to have her not sleep. Dark meditation. That is wicked. This is just awesome. I love it. She looks so pleased with herself. Okay. Oop. So. Yes, as I said, I'm going to leave it here. I will continue with a series with this, actually. I'm quite excited to delve into vampires a bit more, so I might make this a separate series from my main one. There'll be a Paige Fairchild series and a Victoria McQueen one. Alright, thanks for watching, and if you liked it, please give it a big thumbs up, leave a comment below, and subscribe. Bye!